What's good? What's good? What's good, everybody? It's your boy Snow Ignorant Gamers in the house. What's good, my G's? G stands for gamers, and I am here to check out the latest demo of NBA Live 14. These guys have been missing since NBA Live 2010, if I'm not mistaken, and I haven't been an NBA Live actual paying customer since NBA Live 2006. I backed out for various reasons, and I could be a fan, but I ain't the kind of person that's just gonna be oblivious and blind to
EA
everything that's
Sports.
going on.
It's in the game.
And these guys got very lazy. And what I mean by lazy, I mean lazy. I mean they just was not keeping up. Just a little history about my whole EA thing with Live. I've been with Live not since 1995, but since NBA Showdown, which is 1994. So, 2K series, which is originally a Sega series, and I am a Sega kid.
Live
It's always been on their
14,
back. And when they got to the
man.
Dreamcast, that Sega Saturn NBA action game that they had was pretty dope, but when they got to the Dreamcast, it got
It's
very real.
coming.
And I didn't buy the Dreamcast. My brother ended up having it. Don't think that I never pay attention to this game. There was few things that I needed them to do to fix the game for me to play. And by the time 2006 came, 2005 came, I think they did it. 2007 was like the big one for me, but 2006, that was it. So let's just get into here. I assume this is what was designed for me to play. I'm from New York, so why not? Both teams are equally shit right now, so that's fine. Actually, are you gonna let me play with another team? Yeah, okay. So we go with that. And I don't care about none of that stuff. So I've seen the footage, and it looked crazy to me. What the hell's going on outside? Seen the footage, it looked crazy to me. I've seen the reviews, sounded crazy to me, but it didn't look too far off. I'm from the gameplay area, gameplay over graphics, but god damn it, you cannot ignore how the graphics look on those videos versus what I actually seen in person from the NBA 2K14 of the same current next gen system. So
Welcome to this Wednesday
I'm
matchup
here
of NBA Squads,
right
presented
now
by
off the back. Like,
ESPN
the
on EA
presentation's looking
Sports.
pretty good.
I'm your host,
ESPN on
Jaylen
EA.
Rose. The Cleveland Cavaliers are readying
Let's
themselves
see. I
for an
mean,
Eastern
it's
Conference showdown
so
against
far
the
so
New York
good.
Knicks.
You gotta love that.
Sitting
It's
out,
looking like
Mike
Madison
Green,
Square Garden.
JVG for the call.
That bottom part with those
Welcome
cabs looks a
to
little
Madison
funny, but
Square Garden in New
whatever.
York
The stadium
as we
looks
get
good.
set for the Knicks,
Those character
looking for
models
their
look
fourth
good.
win of the season
Of the
against the
girls.
visiting Cleveland Cavaliers.
All this stuff looks
Hello,
good
everyone.
right here.
Along with Jeff Van Gundy, Mike Green on hand. We're
And
getting
here's
ready
where
for
it
the
gets a little
opening tip,
funny.
but first, let's
Seems
take a
like they
look at
went with a
tonight's
less
starting
detailed
lineups.
approach.
All right, as this game gets
All the
underway,
players seem to be a
Jeff,
little
anybody that
slim.
stands out in your mind that they need to focus on against the Cavaliers tonight?
Crowd
Well,
seems
the
to be in
thing that you
attendance.
have to worry about with Bynum, but you can't take away, is his
Live players
massive
have always
size
looked
and length.
slim, like even Eddie
This
Curry.
guy
Oh, what's the going on
is
with the
ever
jersey on the right?
improving. He scores efficiently in the low
There's way
post.
too much animation
He's
going
a
on in
great
these
offensive
jerseys.
rebounder. The thing
In the
is, you've
uniforms.
got to push him outside of the
All
paint.
right.
In the
First
paint,
things first.
devastating.
I
Outside of the
never
paint,
play
you
live
can
in this
deal
view.
with Andrew Bynum.
Let's see.
Freddie pump fake gets off the shot.
All right,
Bynum
let's
with the
try
rebound.
probably 2 minutes like this, or a couple of possessions, and then I'll see what's up. So, it doesn't move as bad as it looked in the reviews, but it
Look, you can't
moved
give
like
up
a
layups
live
like
game.
that.
But I'm
You
gonna
got
tell
to
you right
attack
now,
the
one of the things
basket
that's really
and
irritating
attack
me
at all
off the
costs.
back is crazy
Brave the
animation.
Celtic with it,
Oh, there was
taking
a
it up.
vibration in my joystick just now. The crazy
Gets it
animation
right back.
with these
To
goddamn
Chandler.
jerseys. I don't understand why
You're all
the
over him.
animation is
Gets off the
so
hook
crazy.
shot. Really good job clogging the lane right there. Kyrie
No,
Irving
like
with
it,
the
look at
ball
my
in
look at the chest
possession.
of my player. Hold on, let's see if I can get it to do it real quick. It just seems like
We've
It seemed like he has a weight vest under him or armored vest under him. That same live bullshit happens. And like my chest is jumping. Like, look at my shorts. But that's way too much. My controller's okay. My controller's vibrating because of the timer. Can I call like a pick or something? See.
Toughness. I think he has set a better tone throughout his NBA career.
Pro hop, mellow to the bucket, skip buckets, press R3 for replay.
Everybody knows
that's a good way to streamline a replay situation. Okay.
Much better and much more proficient in how he
You know what? It's been a couple of possessions. And I can't do it. So live wants me to play like this. This is not a view. This is not the typical view I would play live in. Did you see the chest? Did you see the chest of number 21?
But then their defense started to drop a little bit.
Alright, let's go. There's some sticky stuff going on here. Dribbling looks pretty good. I mean, it's the right way it was supposed to.
Chandler.
Let's see what we can do here. He's not known for scoring, but I'm just trying to see if there's any kind of like feedback on the post-up game.
No doubt about
that's
that
pretty
one.
Cool.
That's
I mean, this feels like a live game, which is a good thing and a bad thing. It's a good thing if you've been playing NBA Live all your life and you got upset that it's been gone since 2010. Anthony. It's a bad thing showing that there's been no real Johnny innovation. Blocked. And what I mean... innovation, I mean like of the character models. Yes, they got some details here. Yeah, there's some player movement here. It doesn't look motion captured heavy like it does in other games. But at the same time, there's some sticky stuff that I've seen already. But it just feels like NBA Live.
Raymond Felton with the ball.
Some of the stuff seems to be... Oh, get off me. Pass out. Let's go to Melo.
Excellent ball movement around the perimeter. Forced to make the pass.
What the hell was that?
Felton against
Melo doesn't pass.
Anthony the jumper.
Yeah, I'm sucking right now, but still. There's just some things in here that already, just off the demo, I mean, it does play bad. I mean, it does play good. Not as bad as the reviewers are saying as far as what's on this court. Where the problem comes into play is the way that it's accessible and the visual stuff from the 2K series. That's exactly what it is. And you know, the crowd looked pretty nice down there. How they got up like that? But just I don't know.
Falling away gets it off.
I don't know. Let's see what this touchpad thing is about. Is there any integration of it in there? Alright, hold on. Let's get something going on. Quick screen. Can I get a pick or something? Isolation ain't really worth about it right now.
Ooh, he gets him to commit. And Carmelo
the
Anthony
net looks good.
Nice shot for two.
Let's see. I need a...
Irving against Felton.
Let's see. Inside. Motherfucker's still running around you.
Nice touch.
That's pretty good.
That's nice body control right there on that layup. Good finish.
And I meant that in a bad way.
Chandler. No question. Yep, that's a foul called
foul
against the Cavaliers.
Okay.
That's their first
see the jerseys
foul
move.
In the last
see the
two
jerseys
minutes
move. There's too much weight in
great
the jerseys.
To take that charge, but just a count late. Didn't have his feet set. Anthony the jumper.
The shooting motion seems to be a little off. I feel like it's still stuck on the when I press it shoot versus when I want to shoot. There's a couple of motions that is in the way. Like I take a gather or whatever. It's like yo, if I'm, it's like our arcade shooter. Like you just go, you press shoot, you shoot. So like I press the button and he just does it. He doesn't really gather himself up in a manner that would happen more realistically. And this is a sports sim, so I can say that. it wasn't a sports sim, to block. If it wasn't a sports sim, I couldn't say that.
And there's the buzzer. First quarter comes to an end. The Knicks down by six. We'll be right back with more Wednesday night basketball.
I don't know if this game was worthy of such terrible reviews.
Really distinguished themselves.
I mean, like,
you,
people crushed this game.
Nothing.
Again, for live fans, you know, if they've been wanting live, this would be like, okay, well, at least I get live back. Will it be, is it, in my opinion, as much as I don't want to say what's better or not, I had 25 minutes to play with NBA 2K, and I am only in here for about whatever the duration of this is, and clearly, 2K is more appealing on the eye. I see the little reflection off the ground, but if anyone's been to the Garden, there's a couple of reflections missing. Oh, Meta, what's good, baby? What's good? And
puts it up.
Let's see if we get to the foul line.
There's the whistle, and he'll head to the line to shoot.
I mean, the crowds look good and everything. Like, it's all right. And here's like the close up where it gets a little funny. And
knocks down the first one.
The commentary is very dry. That I gotta say.
No back-to-back free throws.
Commentary
is
dry.
The second.
It feels very unchanged. It doesn't seem like it's like they're using the old way of doing it. Versus it seems very like no matter who you using, no matter who you do anything with, it's going to be the same way. Like, it's not going to say, like, you know, Melo for three or something like that. It's like he goes for this and the blah blah blah. Like, they're not putting any names on it. Let's see. All right, is that JR? Can we get like a pick or something?
Knicks made some changes this year, including Andrea Bargnani. An interesting acquisition for them. Obviously a former number one pick. Can he really help this team?
Yeah. I like the trade.
I don't know.
Now look, when you're viewing him through the lens of has he been a successful number one pick in the draft, the answer is absolutely not. As a number one pick, total bust. All right? But that doesn't mean he can't have a successful second opportunity. Stop looking at him as a number one pick and look at him as, can he be helpful to an NBA team? And he has a skill level that should help the Knicks spread the floor. Hey, you can only control what you can control. The defense there was great. It was just a better shot.
Slams it home.
Scoring in the paint is not for the faint of heart. You've got to expect to get hit and hit often. He's not whining and complaining. He is just getting them baskets right at the rim.
Now, notice I didn't say any real names or anything like that. Like,
in possession.
That's very static. It was dynamic back in the days, but that is static now. Let's see.
To Martin.
You want this ball, Martin? Like, you gonna do something, baby? Let's go. You missed Trey Martin. So, I hope you guys saw the players get up off the bench and how they walked over.
To Irving.
You see him walking over. And it looks very lifelike.
Goes to the goal, flips it up, shot.
It's the little things, which is what everyone is so used to now. With live being gone, it's no longer acceptable.
Oh, telegraph that pass, an easy pickoff.
I can see where people are like feeling some kind of way about this game. But for someone that's a purist of the NBA Live, this is your NBA Live that you purchased back in 2010.
Like, tied up, has to make that pass.
There's been some model upgrades, there's been some animation upgrades, and again, I'm just talking about purely what's on this on the floor right now. I'm not talking about any modes or features, anything like that. But for this experience right here,
it's a turnover off the
that's what it
pass.
Is. And you see he just intercepted the pass.
Sloppy
there
play.
Was a tap, and then I just intercepted it back, and then there's a bad throw that I couldn't get the ball. What the hell's going on?
Whistle sound.
And it finally went out. I couldn't see it. Okay, that's weird, but that adds to the actual sin factor of the game. Yo, that's crazy. But you know, I'm trying to look for some
Cleveland bringing it
not justification, but god damn it. Like, I've been playing 2K for a while now, and let me tell you, man, like,
dunk. Oh, that's nice right there.
The this just doesn't cut it nice for me dunk. No more. And it's sad because Live is responsible for pushing the envelope of basketball games. Don't get it twisted. Don't get it twisted. Like, they pushed the envelope for so long. Even when they were starting to get stale, they were still pushing the envelope. And 2K had their 1-2 punch, and it was working. They were just like a few little tweaks away. And I feel like from 2003 to 2006, they worked on every goddamn tweak known to man. Because when I got into it in 2006, I couldn't look back at Live. I had friends that would still buy it. I would still play it.
You can't go for the but home run swing. You've got to
I just couldn't look back.
Simple each possession and generate a quality shot.
Good blocks. I like the blocks. There's a lot of blocks going on in here. I think that's correct. You just can't be shooting over motherfuckers like that when you do stupid shots. But man, this is definitely Live. It's just, it looks very stiff at the same time.
Lets it go, puts it in, and they extend the lead to double figures. Smith, final seconds of the quarter, just flips it up.
It just looks very stiff, except for the jerseys and the net. And then the net, the jerseys feel like it got like weighted vest under them. I don't really have a problem with the player models. I mean, this is something that we've been dealing with for a long time between two games. One game will get it right, the other game will, they don't look terrible, they just don't look as good as NBA 2K's.
The Cavaliers dominated this matchup from the opening tip. They certainly staked the flag in the paint. They were dominant around the rim on the offensive end.
His halftime highlights is terrible, though. I mean, this presentation looks good, but it's so dry. This is dry, like.
These are the guys getting buckets for the Cleveland Cavaliers.
Yo, you hear that pause? These are the guys getting buckets for the Cleveland Cavaliers.
Mike
like,
Brown kept his team in check while they enjoyed the first half lead.
This is very
with ESPN Wire.
Back in the day-ish.
Shots, keep boxing out. Keep contested shots, keep boxing out.
Oh, they didn't say that. Shot, okay? Look what's in there. Oh, that's cool.
The New York Knicks.
The Knicks were definitely sluggish.
That looked pretty good right there.
And when you're having a game like this one, I know what it could be like to be in that locker room.
I mean, it has potential, but
I've been relying on these guys for their scoring here today.
Relying on these guys. You don't point out the names, like score, the
Mike
points.
Mike Woodson got into his team while down on the scoreboard.
All right, here's the wire.
ESPN Wire.
Long shots.
See the jersey move rebounds. For no reason.
So get yourself in position to rebound the basketball, all right?
Very quick to the point.
Game track. Points in the paint.
The New York Knicks are in a situation where
the New York Knicks
the coach of the
are
team,
like that
I
pause.
Hope they'd be insulted by the way they gave up points in the paint. Going into the second half, these guys really need to have some pride and be more assertive around the
look
basket.
Look how heavy the jerseys are. Like
these
they've got life, but
right
they're
away.
Heavy.
And they also need to go away right away. They've also got to have to figure it out. And now up on the screen, the first half stats.
Yeah, this shit is so undynamic.
Player of the half.
Kyrie Irving has made an impact with this scoring in this matchup. I'm thinking he made a promise to himself before the game that he was going to own the paint with his offense. So far, he has not broken that promise.
That was the killer crossover. Shout out to Tim Hardaway. And just leave it so dry. You get what I'm saying? Like,
we close out this segment with a look at the shot chart.
Oh man, talk about being spoiled. Like, this is like a relationship with someone, and you don't realize how great they've been to you until you leave them and go to something else.
You're not on fire.
Or the other way around, since I was a live person. Like, you didn't know how outdated and underappreciated that the person that you used to buy into was of you, and now you found something new. And it's so much better. Like, how could you go back to this? And I'm trying to be positive. Like, this is potential. But, like, God damn.
Number two.
Hold on. I got dunked on. There should have been better plays than that. I mean, it's cool that they have that in there, but it just lacks the flair. Oh, they put defense as part of the top play. That's what's up.
And that concludes our halftime report. Thanks for joining us. And
NBA
see you again
Wednesday.
After the
and
game.
Today is Wednesday, by the way.
Hello again, and welcome back to Madison Square Garden.
So, for the second don't worry about the score. Jeff Van Gundy, I'm still trying to figure the shit out. Tonight,
Mike Breen on hand.
But
New York's trailing once again at halftime, Jeff. But this is a
I don't even know how to call
a
pick.
Yeah, and they do it because they
and it's very easy for him to get past me, by the way. Like, I'm not too fond of that.
And you always give yourself a chance for a comeback when you work at the game as hard as they do.
Bargnani.
That's not where I was passing to, but.
Jeff, one of the fun parts of our job are watching a young
it's,
into the league.
Let's check that out. Oh, it removed it already? Okay, that's fine.
It sure looks that way, Mike. And I'm
having a hard time calling for picks.
The next step is team success. And how do you get team success? You get enough talent tied together.
So annoying.
Who wants to play both?
So I got what?
Kyrie Irving's
L2.
Offensively,
what is L2?
Cannot be questioned. He has everything you need to
okay.
be a dominant offensive
That was it. That was a terrible
league.
Pass.
And the next step for him as a player, as an individual, and for their team is defensively. To commit
so if I
every
press
night
L1,
to doing the
do I get help?
Of defense
R1.
And rebounding. I think it's going to be important for Kyrie Irving to make a better effort.
Help him out. He's going to get body down there.
So
help him out.
Team follows suit.
That should have been a block, but whatever.
And Andrea Bargnani with the hand.
So I think I found the pick button, which we're going to
against Irving.
Get to Melo. No. Come set this pick, motherfucker. I'm Melo. I ain't passing to you. Set the pick. Okay, so I didn't find it. But we're just going to take
this
throw hop.
Three left on the clock. Hey, sometimes good offense beats good defense.
I mean, it has its points where it looks really good.
That possession. That was a well-defended, well-contested shot.
It's hard. It's hard. And I tell you what. You see that? What's happening right there? That ain't got nothing to do with Felton. That ain't got nothing to do with me. There's going to be a lot of that shit.
You've
got to
stay between your man and the basket versus getting broken down. Off the dribble to Anthony.
Let's see. It's like they didn't even fix their control. Oh,
they double him.
Wow.
Shot clock to one. Can't hit from way outside.
It's very stiff. I feel like I'm pressing the controllers hard to do stuff that. It's not happening. It's not to say the controls are not responsive.
Oh, nice rejection by Chandler.
It's just showing you like what's going on with the game. And I like that what just happened in the hole just now, by the way. Like, that was pretty cool.
Gets it up for two. Cans the jumper. And Carmelo Anthony with 12.
There was
points.
Collision. They hit the ball. He didn't get the shot off. I like that. But for some reason, like all the players, like they seem to be the same. The same models, just with different heights on them. Like Felton's a little heavier. but this has been an issue that we've had with previous ones too.
To the basket,
and
flips
foul.
It up, and a foul called against the Cavaliers. Their first.
I'm trying not
foul.
To skip any scenes. That wasn't
and
on me.
On to the line.
See, like now he looks
throws.
A little heavier here, but when from that view that we're playing, it doesn't seem like he has that weight.
And he connects on the first free throw.
Okay, looking in the crowd. Doesn't seem like anybody repeated there. I'm looking for the same motions.
Second
not sure what happened
the
there. That got away from me, but that's just a learning curve. Oh, no. See, this dude set a pick. What the fuck?
Passes it right back.
Alright, I know what I do.
Bynum.
When I get the ball, I'm gonna see what the circle button does. Oh, you saw that, right? Let's look at that again. You saw the jersey jerk? Did you see the jersey jerk? Look at the jersey jerking on. This is crazy. Chandler jersey was jerking for no reason. You see the jerk again? Yo, what the fuck? Alright.
Chandler.
Whoa, why did circle?
To Felton.
We got two. Can I get a pick? Can I get a pick, somebody?
To Anthony, fires away from downtown. Won't go from outside the arc.
What's up with that pick?
Kyrie Irving with it, taking it up. Bynum.
I don't know, man. I love that though. You hear that sound?
For two, lets it go.
That's gorgeous the NBA shot clock sound for. This is a legendary sound. It's been there forever.
Anthony.
All right, can we please get a pick?
Puts it up for two, and he's fouled. And with the foul call, he'll get to the free throw line for the
see
first
the jersey.
Time
why
in the
is
game.
The jersey jumping? Why are you jumping?
First free.
What the hell? What the hell? So it wasn't the PlayStation. It's the game. And you know what? I wanted to see the final game wrap up. But I don't think this is going to happen. I don't think that's going to happen. So not only is this shit just like not really working, but you do this. Yo, Ignorant Gamers, your boy Snow. This was my playthrough of the NBA Live 14 demo from EA Sports, EA Games, Electronic Arts. And it's go hard or go home season for these guys right now. And you know what? This has been absent from the market since 2010. And NFL 2K has been missing since 2004, I believe. Or 2K, was it 2K5? Because they always put a year ahead. Whatever the case may be. I think it was 2K4. If Madden loses their license, exclusivity to the NFL license, the 2K football game was great when it left. And you guys might have missed all pro football with Joe Montana, Elway, Barry Sanders, and them was in it. That was a phenomenal game. If live is looking like this against NBA 2K, you guys wait and see what NFL 2K looks like against Madden. And this is from an EA kid. And I'm rooting for 2K on a low because that came from Sega's pedigree. And I love Sega. So they need to go back to the drawing board as they started to do when they wanted to call it NBA Elite 11 or whatever it was. And I'm not saying tear the game down all the way down. But the on-court action needs to be reimagined, recreated, because the competition on the court is fierce. I'm out. I don't want to drag this no more. Holla at your boy. My name is Snow. Peace out, my G's. Keep gaming. One.